Hi, this is Abid Hussain Malik from Abid Financials. Today we shall discuss QuickBooks Online Level 1 Answers, Section 3, which name is Expenses and Vendors. There are total 5 sections in this exam and 10 questions shall be asked in Section 3, Expenses and Vendors. There are some rules we shall discuss for this exam. There are two methods to take the certification exam. First one is direct testing and second one is standard routes. The 80% marks are required for each section. Take the exam in one sitting. Maximum 3 attempts are available for each section. And if you pass the exam, download your certificate from Kelly.com. If you fail, then it will be locked for 30 days. Then you shall be eligible to take your exam again after 30 days. If you will pass level 1, then you shall be eligible for level 2 certifications. And Abid Financials, we provide the following services to our clients: bookkeeping, accounting, payroll, taxation, and we also provide the certification services for QuickBooks Level 1, Level 2, payrolls, desktop, enterprise, and the intuitive bookkeepers. We also provide the Xero Pro Advisor and the Xero payroll certification. You may contact at my email address and WhatsApp number for urgent services of the certifications. Or if you have any question, you may leave your question in the comment section of the video. I shall reply you as soon as possible. This is my contact number and email address. You may visit my YouTube channel Abid Financials and the website abidfinancials.com. This is my WhatsApp number. And let's start our question one. And the question one is, you generally need to submit 1099 to the IRS at year end when you pay more than how much for services for a vendor who is an independent contractor or freelancer. There are four options: $60, $600, $6,000, $16,000. The correct answer is $600. Question 2, which of the following statement best describe tags in the QuickBooks? There are four options. Tags are best way to generate reports to analyze the financial data based on location. Option B, tags are highly structured and typically used for high level categorization. Option C, tags are customizable labels that you can add to transactions that affect the profit and loss account. D, tags are integrated into all standard reports and offer advanced filtering and sorting capabilities. The correct answer is, tags are customizable labels that you can add to transactions that affect the profit and loss statement. Which of the following are the benefits of using purchase orders? Select all the options you think apply and then select submit. There are six options here. Creates clear communication between clients and vendor, helps vendors successfully generate and deliver, reduces the need for financial audit, eliminates the need for contract between clients and vendors, helps and manage the client's cash flows, makes orders easier to track for clients. The correct answer is A, creates clear communication between clients and vendor, then B, helps vendors successfully generate and deliver the client's order, and then E, helps manage the client's cash flow, and the last one, correct answer, makes orders easier to track the clients. Question 4, which of the following statements about purchase order is false? There are four options. Once a purchase order has been created and its status is open, when the clients receive the items from the purchase order, it can be copied to bill. Purchase order is an accounting transaction, which means it affects balances in your client's account. When the client receives the item from the purchase order, it can be added to an expense. The correct answer is, a purchase order is an accounting transaction, which means it affects balances in your client's account. Question number 5, which of the following statement about recording money out transaction using item is false? You can record money out transaction using item instead of or as well as categories. Recording money out transactions using item enables tracking at a more detailed level. To add items to sales and expense forms, you must switch on the option to show items table on the expense and purchase forms. You specify the purchase account for item when you create an expense or bills. The correct answer is option D. You specify a purchase account for item when you create an expense or bill. Question 6. What happens when your clients receive a credit from a vendor? It can be used for a future purchase from the vendor. It increases the cash balance, can be applied to an existing open bills, decreases accounts payable liability on the balance sheet. Correct answer is option A. It can be used for a future purchase from that vendor, and option C. It can be applied to an existing open bill, and option D. It decreases the accounts payable liability on the balance sheet. Which of the following vendors' details is it best practice to maintain in their record in the books? Four options: account number, address, email address, open balance. The correct answer is account number, and second correct answer is address, and third correct answer is opening balances. You are configuring the expense option in accounts and setting for a client so that they can specify which product and services are purchased from vendors. You switch on show items table on expense and purchase form. Which of the following forms does this add a pair of product options? There are five options, and the correct answer are purchase order, bill, vendor credit, and expenses. These are four correct answers. When your client spends money at the time of purchase, what should be used to record the transaction in QuickBooks? Four options: purchase order, expense, sale receipts, bill. The correct answer is an expense. Option B is correct answer. When might a client want to manually record an expense rather than categorizing it when it comes in through the bank feed? And when a large expense is incurred, when the pay is a new vendor, when the expense needs to appear in a company report immediately, when the expense is greater than 10. The correct answer is option A, when a large expense is incurred, and the option C, when the expense needs to appear in a company report immediately. What happens when your client receives a bill and record it in QuickBooks? And there are four options: increase accounts payable balance, increase expense on the P&L, debits the expense account, credits the accounts payable. All four options are correct answers. A, B, C, D are correct answer. In which tab of the transaction center do the bills and receipts appear after they are added to QuickBooks? There are four options: bank transaction, app transaction, receipts, and rules. The correct answer is receipts, option C. What is the best way to record a payment made to a credit card to ensure that it's categorized accurately in QuickBooks? There are four options. It should be categorized to an expense account, recorded as a credit card credit, and be recorded as a bill payment, and it should be recorded as a pay down credit card transaction. The correct answer is it should be recorded as a pay down credit card transaction, option B. When does switching on show item table on expense and purchase form option in account and setting enable your clients to do? There are four options. The correct answer is automatically categorize expenses in the bank feed. Option C is correct answer. That's all for today, and if you have any question, please let me know at the comment section of this video. I shall reply you as soon as possible. Or if you need any urgent services for certification, you may contact me at my WhatsApp number or email me at info@abidfinancials.com. I shall reply you as soon as possible. Besides this, you may visit my YouTube channel Abid Financials, where you can find the study material of level 1 QuickBooks Online level 1, and you may also find the answer of level 1 here. And besides this, you may also find the answers of Advanced QuickBooks Online, QuickBooks Online Payroll, Xero Payroll, Xero Pro Advisor Certification, and you may also find the videos for QuickBooks Online Training Full Course. If you want to learn about accountings or any topic, you may just leave me a message. I shall create a video for you. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day. Please subscribe my channel and share with your friend. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.